It is NBA action on EA Sports. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by Jay Williams. Should be a terrific game here tonight. From the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden in Midtown Manhattan. Tonight, the New York Knicks taking on the Miami Heat. The jump controlled by Miami. Shot from the lane won't go. To Julius Randle. Kevin Knox. No, I missed a short one there. And a throwdown.
That probably won't be the last time we see a dunk from him tonight. Maybe sometimes you should send a message. Give him a hard foul. Don't let it be so easy.
Smith. Add 2 points to the board.
2 points. Take them any way you can get them.
Dragic with the basketball.
He'll run the offense. Beyond the arc for three. His first effort off the mark. He's fouled. A couple of free throws coming up, Jay.
Guys like Gary Payton would always take ones early like this all the time. Number one, to see if they'll get caught. And number two, to leave a little mark on you to remind you that they'll be on you all game long.
And hits the first free throw. And gets both to drop at the line. Jay, sometimes it's not just the Heat that does opponents in Miami.
I've been a victim to this multiple times when we have played the Heat, and I think other franchises from cold cities have been the same. There's a reason why the Miami Heat have such an advantage down here on South Beach. You catch them on an off night, it's rare that teams, opposing teams, are ready to play.
Smith to the basket, but it stays out.
It's easy for the offense to get agitated when you keep turning around and the defense is right there in your face. The jawing is only going to escalate.
Goran Dragic. First couple didn't go. That one is true.
Great job using that shoulder to create contact with the defender without hesitation.
Smith. Knocked loose. That's going to be out of bounds. Dennis Smith Jr., short jumper off the mark. To Butler. Gets a look, can't hit.
That's how you do it. You keep riding him to the basket, and if the refs aren't calling it, keep being physical. Keep knocking him off balance.
Kevin Knox powers it through. Jay, I'm surprised he had a chance to wrap him up.
Well, you're not the only one surprised. This guy is not a good free throw shooter. You never let him have an easy bucket. If anything, make him earn it at the charity stripe.
Smith with it up top. 2-point advantage. Kelly Olynyk. Huge block. Couldn't keep it in. Out off Kelly Olynyk. Smith. Throws it down. He climbed the ladder on that one.
Well, the question is, how big is the ladder? He's still climbing.
Dragic into the front court. Down four. For three. Well, their first three, and they're right back in it. Within a possession in this first quarter.
Well, I don't want to live in the past, but if you got a couple of those that dropped earlier, they could have had a nice lead. Now, we got a dogfight.
Ah, rock in the rim.
It's a new day in sports when you see little guards dunk the ball like they're big. That's called a 40-inch vertical.
Muller to bring it up. Down three. Oh, mistake there as the pass stolen by the Knicks. Another chance. And the rebound taken by Butler. Gets it to go. Could have been more. A lot of contact, but no foul.
And sometimes less is more. Keeping it simple, is the best way.
Smith now into the front court. His team up by one. Reset here. Let's see what they do. And a putback slam.
Ed, it's pretty amazing how athletic bigs can be when it comes to getting an easy 2 points, huh?
Butler into the front court. Looking to make something happen. Nice pass to get things going.
Contact on a drive can be a beautiful thing. Making those tough shots can really help you build a mental advantage over your defender.
Smith to Julius Randle. Kelly Olynyk able to recover with the block.
Sent a message on that one, Ed.
We get a whistle and a timeout here for Miami as they'll discuss matters in what's now a 3-point game. Both coaches dipping into their reserves. Changes coming onto the floor. Fires the three. Oh, good offense beating good defense.
Man, you making people dance out there? I see you with the footwork.
Payton into the front court. The score, 14 all. Denied.
Oh, big man doing work right there.
Butler on a pass stolen by the Knicks.
It's early. Get a good quality shot here.
Knocked loose. Kevin Knox. It goes down.
They're going to have to find answers defensively and quickly because he's carving them up in the first quarter.
Knox with the board. Payton with the basketball. Lead is two. Gets it in the left corner. Runners good there.
I see this happen all the time. It used to happen to me. Sometimes an easy offense allows more effort to translate to the defensive end.
He'll go to the foul line to shoot.
It's still early, so no real impact on that call. But you know that they're going to call this one tight, so you might want to keep your hands out of his pocket.
Oops, he missed the first one. Knocks down the second after missing the first. New York in control of the basketball. Elfrid Payton sizing up Butler to Marcus Morris. Udonis Haslem sends it away. Calls out of bounds. Last touch by Udonis Haslem. Payton. Shot from in close. No good.
0-4 to start the game. Don't worry about that. You can make your next six shots and then be 6 of 10 from the field. That's 60%. That can get you $80 million.
That reach was just about a second off. He got his hand in there a little bit quicker. That would have been a steal.
Just enough imbalance. Three, shooting. Misses the first. So he goes 1 for 2 from the line after hitting on the second. Waiters. Textbook defense.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get that offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
2 points. The assist from number 6.
Butler to bring it up. Less than a minute to go in a tightly played first quarter. Cashes in for 2.
That boy's living his best life.
Let's see what the Knicks can do here. Oh, the Heat right there to take it away.
Defense, let's go.
Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say no foul.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed. It's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket.
Payton into the front court. They can go 2 for 1 if they hurry. Converts in the paint. Nice finish at the rim.
There's certain guys in this league that should be put on alert status 24/7 because either they're posterizing you or that attempt can still be a poster.
Ayton on the drive, but it won't go. Nothing going here on that drive. And count the basket. Long heave from three-quarters court. First quarter in the books with the Heat in front. Second quarter set to start. This is what we like. This game is certainly in the balance.
Well, both teams had their rhythm. They established the tempo that they wanted to play at. But ultimately, something has to give. Some team has to draw a line in the sand.
Oh, the touch at the rim. Count it.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball. And there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
To Butler. Off the assist.
And did you see the lift on the shot? Did you see the ball release off the hand? To be able to have the concentration to finish with such a feathery touch in the midst of contact, that's something special to watch.
And a whistle.
Welcome to new age basketball. You blow on me, that's a foul.
Smith to Marcus Morris. Has a look. Deep two there, won't go. The follow won't go either. Butler into the front court. They lead it, 4-point game. Jimmy Butler, he is shooting well. He's made 2/3 of his shots. We talk so much about who are the MVP candidates, but there are other guys who are so valuable to their teams, and Jimmy Butler at the forefront of that list.
I have a phrase that I use when I describe players like Jimmy Butler. It's called most valuable mentality. There are certain players that approach the game with a certain mindset every single day that they will do anything, anything possible to win the ball game. He plays with his heart and soul every single possession and every night, and he will leave it on the court if that means he can win the ball game.
That's usually one that he'll knock down.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Waiters to Butler. Jimmy Butler. That's three now on 4 shots.
Ooh, he teased me a little bit right there. But see, I like that. That's called a great entertainer. Always leaving me on the edge of my seat.
Has a chance. Smith shot. No good. Butler to bring it up. His team on top by 8. And scores on the Euro step.
Ed, you're allowed 2 steps after you pick the basketball up. It doesn't matter which feet you step with, but 2 counts.
Coach of the Knicks signals for a timeout as he'll take a moment to go over things here in the second quarter. Both coaches hitting the reset button. Fresh legs coming onto the floor. Smith to Julius Randle. He was smothered and still gets it to go down.
2 points. Take them any way you can get them.
He wants it at the rim and scores.
There you go. I like seeing his scoring coming from unlikely sources.
Hands up. Smith with the basketball. Trailing by 10. To Julius Randle. Short jumper stays out.
It's easy. Force guys into low percentage shots. That's the reason why we're big into stats. It was all provided to you before the game in the scouting report.
New York Knicks basketball. Knocked loose. He'd come up with it.
That's called game plan execution to perfection. Every possession on the road is critical.
Knocks it down from mid-range.
You know, Ed, people don't understand. Tough shots are practiced every single day. With all these different contraptions out there to contest your shot, guys shoot 500 made shots a day. This is the new norm.
Smith on the drive, but his shot won't fall.
What happened is he didn't balance himself off the defender. He didn't initiate contact. He allowed the contact to initiate him. We could break that down later in the broadcast, but that's why he missed that easy chipper.
Smith. Painted area won't go down. In the slam. That has to feel deflating for the other side.
They've really came out and made a statement so far in this first half. Another powerful dunk, but another easy dunk. When are we going to see some defense?
Count the bucket for two.
And if you don't contest, he's knocking that down with ease.
It's the Heat with the possession. Butler.
To number nine. That's his first personal foul.
Jimmy Butler is going to get a chance at three here. A career 83% free throw shooter. Off the mark on the first free throw. It's the second. One more coming. Payton with the basketball. Down a bundle. To Dennis Smith Jr. Jimmy Butler pins it.
Oh, he blocked that with authority.
Knocked loose. And this will be out of bounds off of Butler. Payton. Nice pass to set things up. And he finishes at the rim.
Shoot. Shoot. Let me see that dance, boy. Let me see it.
From long range. Well defended. Smith into the front court. 14-point deficit. Knocked loose. Heat get control. Active hands to stay with it. We'll get a jump. They're set to jump it up to see who gets possession. Jimmy Butler, he's now 5 for 6.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
Payton to Dennis Smith Jr. Trying to cash in. Wide open look won't go. Basket's good on the follow. Way to stay with it.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays. No one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
Man, he's shifty. Tough defensive assignment. Goran Dragic with the answer.
I love the pure confidence on that jumper. He takes that three despite the defender being right in front of his face. That's borderline disrespectful.
Butler into the front court. His guys hold a commanding lead. That's good D. Shot no good.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
The opposing coach is going to counter, make some changes of his own. Kevin Knox. The jumper's off the mark.
I don't know why he rushed that shot. He was wide open. Take your time.
Watch the cutter, man.
Lays it up and in.
I wasn't quite expecting him to get there, but I can be wrong. Sometimes, not a lot, but maybe sometimes.
I got ball.
Alfred Payton against Leonard. Myers Leonard with a piece. Good. A three at the buzzer. Everything going right so far as they've extended the lead. A very one-sided first half of basketball as we are at halftime. Let's get you to our NBA Live studios in Orlando and hand it over to Jalen Rose for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Jalen.
Fellas, back to you.
First half, very one-sided. What will the second half bring? We'll find out as we're underway. The possession lies with New York. Took it down the lane, but it's no good. To Dragic. Goran Dragic. With that, he's 5 for 9.
Attack mode isn't a switch that you can just turn on and off. He needs to do more of that. We need to see him penetrate, get into that lane, and create.
Nice finish at the rim.
Not always the first option, but his number was definitely called on that one.
Butler to bring it up. His guys lead here early stages third quarter. Stuffs it down with authority.
It's easy to become mesmerized when you watch a player who can create off the dribble. We call that dancing. When you allow a player to dance with that much space, that's prob city.
To Julius Randle. Big finish that time for Julius Randle.
You know, from a point guard perspective, one of the things that I learned when I played in the league was that the more I was willing to give the ball up, the harder other players were willing to run to their spots. The harder the bigs were running to the rim. The harder the three-point shooters were running to the three-point line because they knew they could be active recipients. And when they caught the ball, they knew exactly what to do with it.
Smith to Kevin Knox. Count the basket, and it could have been more. No whistle.
This is where I go back into player mode. If a dude starts to try to have 40 points on me, I'm going to foul out. I'm going to start hitting him in places he's not used to being hit. I'm trying to do anything to throw him off his game.
Just off the mark.
I'm not sure that the contest on the shot contributed to the miss, but what it might have done is seep into the confidence of the shooter that the next time he might decide to try to drive to the rim instead of settling for a jump.
And it's Randle there to take down the rebound. Into the front court comes Smith. His guys down big. To Julius Randle. Off the assist.
Great job using that shoulder to create contact with the defender without hesitation.
Lets it fly from long range. Shot off the mark. Good defense.
Shooters shoot, period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
Dragic with it. His guys holding the big lead. Fires the three. Not easy.
As a defender, you should take it personally when a contested three goes in. That's good defense, but it's not good enough.
Smith. Great feed. Now ready for a couple of free throws.
Just because a team's winning doesn't mean the refs are going to put away the whistle. Play right all the way through.
Dennis Smith Jr., couple of free throws on the way. For his career, 69% at the line. First one goes down. Two for two on that trip. Miami's got it. Dragic. They'll get it down to Leonard. Give him 2 points. High percentage.
I'm not sure that wasn't an offensive foul, but take it when you can get it.
Smith with it up top. Looking to make something happen. Easy pass to the rim.
Did you see the way that dribble freed him up? It created so much space. I did, but the defender didn't.
Butler into the front court. He'll run the offense. Dragic. And the basket good at the rim.
Well, the shooting has been spectacular, but one of the things that I've seen as the difference maker in this ball game is how they are catching the basketball. They're not establishing a pivot foot, which leaves the defense wondering which way you can drive, but when that shot is working like that, you got it any way you want it.
And a putback slam.
And there's nothing more mentally intimidating for your opponent than when your own teammates are unselfish and make sure that you get the ball because they want you to drop 70 on them, maybe like Devin Booker did last year.
Yes, give the advantage to the shooter.
Defense, do the math. You force them to take tough twos, you'll probably have a better chance to win this game if you can slow down the pace.
Dennis Smith Jr., guarded by Myers Leonard. The screen sets him up for two.
Ed, 2 years ago, I was sitting in the draft room absolutely shocked that Dennis Smith went at 9 in the draft. And when I think about this young man's game, he is just scratching the surface of what he can do. He finished tied for 4th among rookies in scoring last season, and I guarantee you, his game is going to continuously go to different levels.
Oh, that's how it's done.
Even though the coach initially may not like that shot, now he's clapping because that ball went in.
Kelly Olynyk rejects it.
That's going to be out of bounds. Smith the last to touch. Dragic. To the rim. Lays it up and in. Possession lies with New York.
Myers Leonard tips it.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
Deion Waiters powers it through.
Huh, what a move. But the move never should have happened in the first place, especially if there's communication from the help side defender. You have to let that guy know which way he can force him defensively to where there's help.
4-3. That one off the mark. It's no good. Nice touch around the basket with the tip.
Sometimes when the players find that flow, nobody else needs to touch the ball. He's in a zone by himself.
Count the basket. A lot of contact. No foul.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed. It's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket. I'm here. I got ball.
And score. Strong take.
Clearly not afraid of the spotlight here because that was not an easy look.
Dragic to Waiters. Going to launch beyond the arc. That's off the side of the rim. Short. Smith now into the front court. Counting down toward a minute to play in this third quarter. Finishing inside the paint on that one.
And ISO basketball is becoming a thing of the past. Team basketball is back. And if you have that personnel with the versatility plus the mindset, game over.
Down low for Leonard. Old school. Backs his man down for the basket.
There you go. Finally, shoot your shot.
Now a whistle, and we'll get a timeout for the Knicks as their coaching staff wants to talk things over here in this third quarter. Looks like both teams are making substitutions. Smith doesn't have the touch. No good.
Your contest was great because of your proximity to the player. You forced his follow through to be cut short, which made him short arm the shot.
Cleans it up. Offensive board. Grabs his own miss and scores. Good concentration.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here yet, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim.
Add another one to his total. That's now 7 threes for the ball game.
And the ball is finding him wherever he goes on the court. Man, that boy, he the best.
Three quarters down, and the Heat right now are feeling good.
So the Heat will have it to start this fourth and final quarter. And it might be time to empty the bench, Jay. This game appears to be well in hand.
And their starting five has certainly earned the fourth quarter off. They've been terrific this ball game. And this is the type of game where you find a chance to relax. You ice up, you watch your other teammates play, you applaud them, and you get ready for the next game.
The drive, right to the basket. Payton on the drive, but it won't go. Deion Waiters. He has struggled just a little bit. 2 for 5.
You know, it reminds me, Ed, of a story a legendary coach once told me. He said, if you ever get in a fight, you're not going to hit somebody with an open hand, correct? You'll probably break a finger. But if you hit somebody with a fist, what is that? That's five fingers working collectively together as one. That's how you deliver a knockout punch, and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Rebound taken by Miami to Dragic. Count the basket. Two more points in the paint.
You know, Ed, I'm down with guys having 35, 40, maybe 50 points in the game. But the one thing you look for in a defensive end, when there's a huddle after a guy has dropped multiple buckets on you in a row, and everybody's quiet, nobody stands up and says, yo, I got him, I'm going to stop him, you're in a worrisome place for your team.
Oh, great pass. Setting up the basket.
As my mother would say to the defender, A for effort, F for results.
Lets it fly from beyond the arc. He drills the three.
You know, from a point guard perspective, one of the things that I learned when I played in the league was that the more I was willing to give the ball up, the harder other players were willing to run to their spots. The harder the bigs were running to the rim. The harder the three-point shooters were running to the three-point line because they knew they could be active recipients. And when they caught the ball, they knew exactly what to do with it.
Waiters. Gets toughness right there. Physical inside, gets it to go.
Let me tell you something that nobody will ever talk about. Did you see him slow down right before he was about to go up? That slow change of speed, that slight change was just enough to throw the defender off.
No good. Dragic. And count the basket inside.
This type of game needs to be celebrated. This is the type of culture that is fostered when you play with unselfish players. When you give up a little bit of yourself and you make your teammate look great, that's the difference between winning and losing. So when you see these guys smiling, when you see them giving each other high fives, that's because of the energy that was created from the pass. Pass is one of the most brilliant things we have in this game.
Payton to Julius Randle. Goran Dragic swats it. New blood coming in for both sides.
For New York, number 9. Into the game for Miami, number 14.
Mama, Dragic. That right there, Jay, his 8th three of the game. He is putting on a show.
He's defying physics with that jumper. He's not even holding his foul through.
Right time, right player.
Can't teach height.
It's the Heat with the possession. Dragic. Nothing going here on that drive. And a nice finish at the rim.
Might have had an extra dribble or two there, but he got the shot he wanted.
Smith with ball, the basketball. Pick up, down a bundle. That's a turnover. It goes the other way. The basket inside.
Well, we got a chance to firsthand watch something be created. I think we just watched an epidemic of passing. I've never seen something like this before. It was so contagious, everybody started to do it, and it ultimately led to the other team's demise.
If that's an epidemic, sign me up. Dragic with the basketball. His guys hold a commanding lead. Cruises inside for 2.
Well, he finished strong because he was able to initiate the contact. When you initiate the contact first, you bounce off the defender, which balances you at the rim.
To Taj Gibson. Taj Gibson, he's now 5 for 6.
And I love when people are saying, well, he's not an exciting player. I don't need him to be exciting. I need him to be fundamentally sound.
And scores.
shot, bro.
Ed, sometimes less is more. Keeping it simple is the best way.
Knicks with the basketball. Smith to Gibson. Bam, Adebayo with the block.
That's why a rim protector is a necessity in this game.
Kevin Knox, down for Smith. Whoa, what a finish.
It's a new day in sports when you see little guards dunk the ball like they're big. That's called a 40-inch vertical.
Now the Heat, gonna use a timeout as they'll make sure they're all on the same page here in the fourth quarter.
Well, first off, energy and persistence conquer all things. But look at the way they're setting screens. Look at the way they're communicating to each other. They're actually hitting people on those screens, and they're coming off those screens with their hands in a target area ready to shoot the basketball. When you play the game with that kind of precision and that kind of energy, you see why they're in the lead.
To Julius Randle.
I got him.
Here's a chance from long range. Rebound's taken down by Leonard.
The game is won in the details. The team who has the most attention to the minutiae is a team that wins the ball game. And from the beginning of this game, this team has been mentally engaged. I know the season's a long year, but when you come mentally engaged and you have attention to detail, whew, that's a scary thing to watch.
Pass stolen by Miami.
Tonight, it may not cost you, but in a playoff game, it will.
Count it.
And that is the sign of an unselfish team. When everybody in transition thinks they have a chance to get the ball because you have a willing passer, somebody willing to make other players on his team look great, that's only going to force your players to play that much harder on offense and give you more energy on the defensive end.
Wide open look won't go. Miami with the basketball. Take stock of the floor. To Dragic. Beyond the arc for three. The hot night continues. He's hit 9 threes here tonight.
Uh-oh, someone's getting towards that single game record territory. He's having that kind of night.
Knocked loose. He'd come up with it.
You better get back on D. This thing is not over.
Goes to the right side. For three, I don't know, Jay. They have a big lead. This game is just about over. He might not make many friends on the other side with that three.
Oh, I don't want to hear that generic coaching speak about dwindle down the shot clock, use the clock is your friend. No, if you have a chance to beat him by 50, beat him by 50. If you want to beat him by 100, keep shooting more threes.
Has a look. Deep two there, won't go. Just inside the arc, at the buzzer, the Heat with the victory as they win this one in very convincing fashion. That'll wrap things up. For Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports.